Good afternoon and welcome everybody to our 1MD live show every Sunday 12 p.m. Thank you so much for joining in week after week and spreading and being our ambassadors and actually spreading information, authentic information about COVID that our experts, Dr. Shashank Joshi and Dr. Shetty, give us every week. I welcome you, Dr. Joshi and Dr. Shetty. Please go ahead, Dr. Joshi, first with the update on what is currently happening in Maharashtra, and not just Maharashtra, but across India. Please go ahead.
Just before that, happy Easter to everybody.
Yes,
today
happy
Easter, the day of the risen Christ. Maybe your celebrations are muted, but happy Easter all the same to each one of you.
Absolutely.
Yes, Shashan.
So, good afternoon, everybody. As we, are just completing the Holi weekend, which is Holi for Holi and Rang Panchami, which was celebrated on Good Friday day. And as we are finishing the fasting of Lent for 40 days in the Catholic community, and today is Easter, so happy Easter to everybody. And in next couple of weeks, we'll have Navratri of Chaitra, Ramadan starting, and festivities and fasting. But the mood is grim and somber in Mumbai and Maharashtra. We are wedded with the second wave. The rapidity and explosive nature of the virus is reasonably awestruck, and we are all grappling with overwhelmed, fatigued, overburdened healthcare system. And I think that's the story across Maharashtra, and we wish and pray that this story doesn't spread across India with the rapidity and spread. We know that this week we saw that India is back to the world number one position in terms of daily cases in COVID, doing around 85,000-90,000 cases per day. Maharashtra itself is reporting around 45,000-50,000 cases a day. And Mumbai has broken every record, from starting from 5,000-6,000 last week to around 8,000-9,000 next week. As I speak, even I am completely knocked out. You know, I took my second shot last Saturday, and I'm still not completely normal. We need to continue our vaccination. Vaccination have their side effects. We have to tolerate the side effects if we have to survive the pandemic. But more than the vaccination, I think it is two things which are going to make a change. Restrictions, 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 and self-care and self-protection. I think if you don't self-protect and self-care, coronavirus is just waiting. As the virus wants to win the war against the human being, we are clearly now seeing that the second wave is infecting faster, infecting larger clusters, infecting families, but it's also recovering faster. Case fatality rate is low. Number of people needing ICU is less. But we still are overwhelmed beds because people do not pay attention in the first week. And after 1 week of COVID, they become complacent. They think COVID has gone. I had no symptoms. And then they suddenly deteriorate in the second week. And that is where we are seeing fatalities and mortalities. So my appeal to each and every person on the show is COVID is very much around. Don't take it lightly. Second wave will always be more vicious than the first wave because you have a smarter, faster virus, probably a little less virulent virus amongst us. It is spreading through airborne droplets. So try to be in open air environments, try to have circulating air, try to ensure that you are sanitized, and try to ensure that you are masked. And unless it is mandatory or necessary, I would not recommend you to venture out and try to do everything digitally, virtually, but still stay cheerful, get your 8 hours of sleep, get your 2 hours of digital detox, eat on time, sleep on time, and do your basics right. But remember, we are having three pools of people now. A large pool of people with suspect COVID, a equally large pool of people with asymptomatic COVID, and a reasonable percentage of people with symptomatic COVID. If you are symptomatic, you definitely need medical attention and care, and ensure that at home or in hospital, you get appropriate care. But if you are suspect COVID or asymptomatic COVID, the wisest thing to do is to save the near and dear ones around you, self-isolate and follow COVID appropriate protocols at home. If this invisible pool of asymptomatic and suspect COVID patients or people cooperate in Mumbai and Maharashtra and in India, we can conquer the second surge. And in 2 to 3 weeks, we can see this surge plummeting down. So this is the story of COVID in its second wave. And clearly, Guru Anna, this has become a big problem. So Guru Anna, my first question goes to you. People are fatigued, people are tired, people just can't handle it, whether it is the frontline workers, the healthcare infrastructure, or people at large. How does one handle fatigue, which is set in COVID, and how do you make them resilient, strong, cheerful, and positive?
Before that, I would like to also share a few nuggets of the virus with everybody. And though both of us look very somber, both of us are fighting this pandemic day and night. Our sleep has been compromised for hunting beds all the time. But across the show, Dr. Shashank will also tell you when to admit, when not to admit, when to stay at home and when not to panic. Before that, Anirudh will put across a slide of the nuggets of the virus. And the most important 4 or 5 features of the virus, which is, I think all of us should actually, the nuggets of the virus. The virus knows no karma philosophy. Anirudh, it is the 6th slide. No issues. Virus knows no karma philosophy. There have been a lot of people blaming others that you have committed sins, so this is why you've got virus. Let's beat that. Let's look at science. This show between me, Shashank, Anirudh is all about science. So no karma philosophy. It is not a Dalit, it is not a Savarn, it's not a Brahmin, it knows no caste, it knows no social status, it loves all equally, and virus is there to stay. Having said that, answering the question of Dr. Shashank of how to really manage your mind amidst this scenario, Anirudh will put up the 7th slide. Let us beat the heat. And how do we beat the heat? Let us not be overwhelmed with corona conversations. Let's have human conversations. How do you feel? Well, I cooked this vegetable, I felt nice. How do you feel? I called up somebody and we had a long chat of everything which we have never talked for a very long time. Yesterday, my mother made a beautiful statement in Tulu. He said, that means in Tulu, you are part of my understand, which means I love you. So keeping this human connection, my mother is 84. And I have a son who's quarantined at home. So keeping these human conversations on is one of the most important quality of a human being, which should be brought up. And Shashank, these conversations also in the ICUs, by the healthcare workers to the patients, don't only look at the oxygen. Don't only look at the D-dimer. Look at it, very important. But ask him, how do they feel? What is his occupation? And listen to 1 minute of a conversation which is human beyond the conversation of COVID. Having said that, you and me, Shashank, and everybody else have had victories and we have had to share our bad news. And we as doctors and healthcare workers and human beings, we always look at the negative aspect all the time. A mother who comes to me with failure of the child in exams talks about one subject which he or she has scored less, but does not talk about the other subjects which he or she has done beautifully. So all the healthcare workers and all of us, let us share our victories loudly. Maine aaj ye kiya, mujhe achha laga, and something happened to the other person, he also felt good. A doctor saying, I took up a patient who was so bad, in a month's time, 60 liters of oxygen, and he went home. Share the victories loudly to stimulate your hypothalamus, to stimulate your hypothalamo-pituitary adrenal axis. That is so important. And share bad news with your colleagues who understand. with your partner in your work or partner at home and see that the tears move and it's shared and dissolved. Work in pairs, health workers, whether doing vaccine duty, whether doing non-COVID duty, whether doing COVID duty, work in pairs. Protect yourself from abuse. A lot of abuse is hurled at people, at healthcare workers. Protect yourself. There's no need to meet people who abuse you all the time. There's no need to meet people who actually talk bad about you. There's no need to meet people who complain against the hospital for small reasons. I had a call yesterday of a patient who was out of COVID, but only 7 days, and there was a problem. I said, go and get admitted in the hospital which is available. Don't go to, I tell students, don't go to branded colleges, go to the nearby colleges. And I tell patients, go to the nearby hospitals for admission when there's only a minor issue. Protect yourself from abuse. And hospitals have an MSW or somebody else who can talk to carers, carers on the phone or in your auditorium if you can, to see that the carers are calmed down, information is passed, and the doctors in the hospitals are not troubled. And also inside your families, have family dinners and crack jokes. Let me tell you, my house is full of laughter. We have a corona COVID patient, my son is quarantined, but we laugh, we crack all the jokes. My mother talks about her childhood. My son on his phone, he talks about how the hell he's feeling inside. He said, I feel I'm jailed, but I'm happy that I'm talking to friends. So keep that alive. And lastly, whether you like it or not, Shashank and me, we have been highlighting the power of exercise, the power of pranayama, the power of good diet. And as you just mentioned, the power of good sleep. Virus will come and go, but let us maintain our body, which is in our own hands. And that, I think, is extremely important. Dr. Shashank, again, I'm asking you. Country has been in the midst of COVID, many states now, and let's not look at why, what, and that, I think, will be something which we'll do in posterity. What are the things, other than not to travel, other than masking, should we all do in COVID, and which is applicable not only to Maharashtra, because we've got questions from Patna, Aizwal, Gorakhpur, and so many places. So what is it that we should all do? You know, I'm really pained, my dear Shashank, when I see the political gatherings in all the states. Nobody's wearing the mask. The candidate is not wearing, his leader is not wearing, the followers are not wearing, drivers are not wearing. I mean, I feel so helpless. So what is it that we should be doing?
I think COVID is going to remain, and COVID appropriate behavior has zero tolerance. And COVID is not going to listen who you are, what party you are from, where are you from. COVID is a simple naked virus, small little RNA virus, which is spreading. And if you don't hear the call of the COVID virus will enter your body. Only thing is that these zones which are not having now a large proportion of cases. See, where has COVID hit us in the second wave? Let us understand that, Dr. Shetty. It has hit us to people who are less exposed. So, for example, in Mumbai, we are seeing an explosion now. 9,000, today I predict there will be 10,000 or 11,000 cases in Mumbai, because we will test around 50,000-55,000 cases. And if we predict that, I predict today our number will be anywhere between 10,900 to 11,000. That's my prediction for today. And in the evening, 6 o'clock, please correct me if I'm wrong. Okay, and today we'll have tested around 50,000 cases. So the numbers are going up. They have to come down. How do they come down? And people who are living in, you know, northeast of India, on Bengal, in Uttar Pradesh, they also have to understand that COVID is still around. You still need to wear your mask, do a little distancing, behave with COVID appropriate behavior, and ensure that you get vaccinated. I think they have a very good opportunity to get vaccinated in all the eligible groups. So I think these are the strategies which we need to adopt, and COVID is very much here. Second wave of Spanish flu, we saw that India was very badly battered after the First World War, and we lost a large population in the second wave. So I think the most important thing, Guru Anna, is across India, across the world, the message is simple. Mask, mask and mask with some sanitization and distance, and be vigilant. See, we can't let our guard off. The minute we let our guard off, when there is an unmasking situation, particularly in an eating situation, you are in trouble. And try to avoid clusters, crowded gatherings, and so on and so forth. So I think, Ruanda, our strategies are not going to change. But human behavior needs a mass change. So these symbols which we are seeing are not sending positive signals. But I think as far as Maharashtra and Mumbai is concerned, I think there has to be a zero tolerance policy. And my worry is that if this continues, you know, we will land up with severe restrictions, which will have not only economic consequences, but I think the consequences will be on the health, not just physical health, Ruanda. It will also have severe consequences and deleterious consequences on mental health, including suicide. So I think the consequences of COVID second wave, if not handled appropriately, are going to be very acutely on the mind, followed by physical health, followed by economy, all the three. And I think right now the priority has to be to apply a circuit breaker. We have to apply a circuit breaker to break the chain.
Before you ask me, Shashank, I would want you to answer these two questions. Sorry, Anirudh. From Bharat Vyas and Pramila Kudwa. Time between two vaccines. Please clear the...
I was just about to ask.
That's a no-brainer. So if you are taking a COVID shield, ideally you should wait for 8 weeks or 12 weeks. And if you are taking Covaxin, you should take it after 28 days. As simple as that. And that is what is the current guidance.
Ask me a question. Yes, Anirudh, go ahead.
No, I was just going to ask the same question, actually, that it is saying, 40 to 60 days at the center, as well as Mr. Poonawalla is saying 90 days. So there is some confusion on their certificate regarding that. So I guess that answer is that question is answered.
No, so as I said, you wait for 2 months and take a second shot. So it's simple, 1 month for Covaxin, 2 months for Covishield.
Excellent.
Thank you, sir. I think, Shashank, I can see a question on the chat, both in our private chats, from somebody who's asking about how to talk to people who's in quarantine. Can you see that? May I answer that, Shashank?
Sure. I think there are three things, Dr. Guru, and I want you to answer. Number one is, how does one handle if somebody has tested positive and tested positive now, Guru Anna, and the person has to stay isolated and quarantined for a good 10 days. Mentally, how should that person cope up? So Guru Anna, I want you to tell them the coping skills. And maybe after that, what I will do is, a lot of people have asked me this question, how should you manage the person at home? So Guru Anna, first you tell, how should they handle and cope up mentally?
Absolutely. And as Anirudh puts on the first slide. First, the family. Family gets angry. They feel sad. They feel anxious. And remember, human beings have a self-preservation software. When it comes to the crux, everybody wants to survive. So there's a lot of anxiety. There's a lot of anger. There's a lot of fear. And sometimes these questions really come up. I told you so. I told you, bahar mat jana. तुम हमारी बात नहीं सुनते हो तुम कहां गए थे पोस्टमार्टम कहां किससे मिला हाउ डिड यू गेट द इन्फेक्शन यू विल ऑल किल अस आई थिंक दीस सेंटेंसेस आर अनहेल्दी सेंटेंसेस व्हिच कम ओनली बिकॉज़ यू आर एंग्शियस यू आर एंग्री एंड यू आर फियरफुल एंड यू आर सैड एंड व्हाट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट हियर इज दैट बिफोर यू टॉक टू योर लव्ड वन शेयर दिस अमंग योरसेल्फ अलग किधर गया था यार अपनी सबकी बैंड बजा देगा ये आई मीन शेयर दिस the anxiety goes down. And for all mothers, let me share a small story. When you're angry with your son or your younger brother or your younger sister, pick up that memory if he's your son or your daughter when he or she was born and you were holding him or her. Everything dissolves. Everything dissolves. Or pick up that childhood memory which is so beautiful with your brother, with your father, with your son, with your husband. All anger dissolves. And what you need to ask, as Anirudh puts on, the do's during quarantine, which is so important, is call him or her. If he or she is anxious, call a little more often. But if you are more anxious, please do not call more often. So call, and when you call, Shashank will tell you what to say. But with respect to mental health, ask him how is he, ask him how does he feel, and let him talk rubbish, let her talk rubbish. Yaar, idhar to aisa lagta hai. And slowly use humor, but inside the humor, drop subliminal messages that he should do his pranayam, he should walk inside the house, he should talk to his friends, he should probably do a little exercise inside his room if he can, if the doctor is allowed. So easy chats also help people understand and remain. So see that you communicate and communicate appropriately and acted adequately. And I said, movement really helps, and that I think is extremely important. As we have repeated this, movement improves mood, movement improves resilience, and movement also improves all the things which are happening in the body. If you have a window in the room, ask him to look out of the window, wave at people whom he doesn't know. There's a building across and say hi, and see to it that he or she is connected to a safe space. Also caution, he or she should not be talking to COVID experts, COVID analysts who do not know anything about COVID and who regularly are, tumne ye kiya, tumne wo kiya, tumne wo kiya, nahi baba nahi. Safe space. COVID is a nude virus, as Shashank said. You need to talk to friends where you can be emotionally nude, who love you, who care for you, who will talk for you and build your resilience. And the necessary instructions which needs to be given, whatever has to be given. And remember, though there is distance between the carer and the person's quarantine, there is contact. Though there is distance, there is compassion. Though there is distance, there is concern. Though there is distance, there is connectivity. And all the four C's will help recovery, because research has shown that connectedness improves immunity, connectedness improves mental health, and healthy connectedness, which I meant, improves the person. So that is what it is. Regulate his calls and see that he doesn't take calls from over inquisitive, highly curious people who ask him all about his investigations and ask him to do a postmortem of why he got the impression. Avoid these guys and talk to those guys whom I've just mentioned. I think that is so important. Communication will improve his health and hasten his recovery. And those who complain inside the quarantine, and you know, sometimes sadness can be converted into pity. Why me? And that's where you need to say that every difficulty poses a challenge. Every difficulty, you can take it as an opportunity to improve your resilience, improve your developmental quotient, and improve your faith in yourself that you will fight not this battle, but many more battles in the future.
So let me tell you, if you get COVID, first thing is that you should see whether you have symptoms or asymptomatic. If you are symptomatic and you are above 50, you have a lot of comorbidities, contact your doctor and try to organize a bed. First thing is that when you are at home, you see whether you have a separate toilet, bathroom, and adequate medications and a connectivity 24/7 with your doctor. It could be a family doctor, it could be a specialist doctor, it doesn't matter, but you need to be connected. At home, you should have some vitamin C, vitamin D, some amount of medications under medical supervision, like an antiviral drug like favipiravir. You need to have a pulse oximeter at home, a thermometer at home. After doing a 6-minute walk test, you must know how to measure the pulse oximeter and wear it appropriately. That's so important. And if you are able to do the proper 6-minute walk test and your saturation is good, you do a CBC, CRP, they are normal. There is no need for everybody to do an HRCT or a X-ray chest unless you have cough, fever. So if you're asymptomatic, most of the time you can manage yourself with or without treatment, but under medical supervision and care. But the most important thing for you that time is to protect yourself and protect who are around your house. Eat well, sleep well, stay connected and be cheerful. And take medicines under medical supervision. Usually the medication given to you at home would be either an antiviral drug like favipiravir. Some people still use doxycycline, ivermectin. Some vitamin C, vitamin D may be given. Some people might give an antibiotic like azithromycin. Let your medical doctor decide what is the best for your interest. And some people might do a blood work also. And you will have to be monitored. If you are into a vulnerable group, high risk group, you are very symptomatic, you are out of breath, you are desaturating, don't wait. Call an ambulance, go to the nearest hospital, and at least let them give you basic treatment. And then you might have to go to a hospital to take a remdesivir with some oxygen, with some steroids. So that is the treatment protocol which is there. So stay connected, and be ready if you deteriorate. Most people who are asymptomatic get restless after 5-6 days. Mere ko kuch nahi hua. And then in the second week, that is the danger week. The danger week of COVID is between 7 to 14 days. And if you are asymptomatic for the first week and you start going out, that is the crucial time. And when that happens, suddenly you deteriorate. And when you suddenly deteriorate, then what happens is that once that sudden deterioration happens, then you know you are hypoxic and then you are struggling for a bed and you don't get a bed for a day or two. And that is where all the problems lie. So I think when you are staying at home, 4 or 5 simple things. Do not panic. Protect yourself and near and dear ones. Ensure that you are masked all the time whenever there is any interaction. Ideal quarantine is fundamentally 14 days. Ensure that you do your tests as well as take your medicines under medical supervision. And most people at home heal very well. The second week between day 7 and 10 is crucial, because if you desaturate, then you may still need to go to hospital. If you follow simple things, simple logic, you have saved yourself. You have saved infecting other people around you. At the same time, you have also ensured that the disease is not spread. Another thing which you can do when you're at home is list down all the people you came in contact with and call up all those people and tell them that, look, I met you in the last 1 week. I am positive. You please isolate yourself first and stay at home so that you don't infect others. If you are by mistake infected, at least for 5 days. And if you are asymptomatic, it is okay. And if possible, try to get testing done. That is contact tracing. I think contact tracing now has to be done by a person who is infected if he is fit enough, if he is asymptomatic. If he's not asymptomatic and he's symptomatic, then he should at least give the list to the healthcare workers so that they know how to track and trace. The other thing which is very, very important is that you must take treatment. Most people are going to recover. And if you feel that you're not comfortable, you have too many comorbidities, then just go and get yourself admitted. And don't worry whether it is a public place or a private place. Go and get yourself treated or get yourself evaluated by a doctor. If not physically, at least virtually. Because once you get connected and a medical doctor has seen you and assessed you, then you know yourself, you will get confidence that you can manage yourself better. And that is the crucial key for home treatment. Home treatment is very tricky. It can be very exacting and you cannot let your guard down. So if you feel not confident that you can't handle all this, then sometimes we suggest you to go to a corona care facility, not necessarily an hospital bed, maybe an oxygen bed. And you can take rest there so that you are supervised. So it's very, very crucial to do that.
So Dr. Joshi, Dr. Shetty, if I may
just one sec. Somebody has asked, can yoga be done? That is Purnima.
Yes. Yoga can be done. Breathing exercises can be done. Jalaniti can be done. So nasal exercises, throat exercises, breathing exercises, all of them can be done at home. Surya Namaskar, Uthak Baitak may not be possible. But you definitely can do a lot of pranayam. Not only yoga can be reducing your anxiety, but also help your lung capacity to expand to the fullest. And nasal yoga exercises also may be very useful as far as COVID is concerned. So there is some emerging data to suggest. The evidence base is not robust, but there is some science to suggest that yoga definitely has an anxiolytic effect. It definitely has an effect to overall aid, assist, and work as an adjuvant therapy during this whole COVID process, because you know you have nose COVID, throat COVID, lung COVID with normal oxygen, lung COVID which needs oxygen. And in the nose and throat COVID, yoga has some very excellent role to play.
Yes, Anirudh.
Yeah. I was just going to ask a connected question. A lot of people have asked personally also and on our Facebook as well. Is that when should people actually decide whether they should get themselves admitted or not? Who should actually go to the hospital? And how do I, what is the test for me to understand in general, when should I decide to go to the hospital, Dr. Joshi?
Just before he answers, I would like to congratulate Arpita Matre, who's a physiotherapist and is taking free online sessions for physiotherapy. And I would really ask you to send your details here on the chat so that Anirudh can Anirudh can share it with everybody. Arpita, honestly, genuinely, very, very good work and congratulations. Yes, Shasha.
What is the question, Anirudh?
Yeah, the question is when do I decide to go to the hospital?
So see, if you are desaturating, if you are feeling breathless, if you are having high grade fever, which is not coming down in one day, if you are having persistent cough, so if you are symptomatic, you clearly need to be in a hospital setup. If you have too many comorbidities and you cannot self-manage, it's time to go to the hospital. Don't get panicky, but start treatment. Even if you are going to the hospital in the bridge time, in that intermediate time, rather than panicking, prepare yourself and handle yourself with a lot of poise and care. That's what is crucial and critical.
Okay. Go ahead, Dr. Shetty.
There is a question, Shashank, for me. I think you can have a look. How to communicate with people who are infected and hospitalized? You said whom should to be hospitalized.
So, I'll ask you the question in a very different way, I would want to you.
Please.
Once they get hospitalized, no, they feel very anxious. And many people are used to luxuries of a hospital. And what happens is that they are used to a single room. Many of them are put in a double room, triple room, quadruple room. Some of them are put in general ward. They are not used to that type of a thing. And you know, in COVID care, everybody is coming to them in a mask. And you know, they are expecting something very different. And in COVID, it's not that. You know, it's like a military discipline. They are coming, giving food, going away. So you know, Guru Anna, it's like a traumatic experience. And then you see that attention is only given to the person who is likely to deteriorate the most. So obviously the medical spectrum of work and the healthcare spectrum is only looking and identifying if somebody is deteriorating or not. The most important thing when you are in the hospital is that ideally you should not strain yourself during the toilet, whether it is passing urine, keep a urinal pot next to you. When you are passing your motions, you have to keep a pot next to you. And those are the biggest challenges which we see. And sometimes they desaturate. In fact, most of the deaths occur at night when they strain for stools or for urination. And that is the time they desaturate. So all these things have to be wired in the mind of the patient. Otherwise, a lot of misunderstandings creep in and they get into a lot of post-traumatic stress disorder. So Guruna, you really need to tell people once they get in the hospital that feeling of isolation creeps up tenfold. So how does one handle that? That is something very crucial, and I think Dr. Shetty, please take your time on this.
Absolutely. As Anirudh puts across the third slide, slide number three, I would congratulate Vinita, a patient with chronic asthma, who says that yogic practices really helped me. So the first thing when you enter hospital, I got calls, please give my close relative a single bed. I told them, in COVID, don't remain in a single bed. Remain with others, and when you enter the ward and lie down there, say hi to the other two beds or other three beds guys around. They might not smile back at you, but when you smile and say hi, they might respond. And what happens is you start getting connected with people who have a similar illness. That's number one. Number two, when the Star Wars characters come in front of you. They come in front of you and see that you communicate. When they ask you, how do you feel? You ask them, how do you feel, doctor? Congratulations and really thank you for doing so much for all of us. This is the time when gratitude is inspiring. This is the time when gratitude is infectious. This is the time when gratitude is inflammable positively to your soul, to your heart, to your body. And I have recalled of incidences where 80-year-olds in the ICU have cheered the intensivists, have cheered the doctors and the nurses. So when you do that, in spite of the oxygen in your nose, it brings back the best out of a doctor. There is connectivity. Ultimately, connectivity improves health. The third most important thing is don't hide your fears. Share it openly. मुझे श्वास लेने में तकलीफ होता है नो डोंट से दैट से मुझे श्वास लेने में तकलीफ होता है मुझे लगता है कि मैं मर जाऊंगा बहुत लगता है डर से इट बी न्यूड विद योर फियर्स जस्ट लाइक यू आर न्यूड विद योर जॉय एंड व्हेन न्यूड विद योर जॉय डॉक्टर्स विल गिव यू साइंटिफिक एक्सप्लेनेशंस ऑफ व्हाई यू आर डूइंग बेटर एंड व्हाई यू नीड टू वेट फॉर सम टाइम टू गेट बेटर हैविंग सेड दिस द Nurses are the frontline COVID warriors. And when they come to you, when they actually come to you, and also, as I've said, gratitude is infectious, inspiring, and inflammable in a positive sense lights your soul through that too. And you find you feeling better. And when you have, when a new drug is introduced, ask the doctor, why am I getting the remdesivir? Why am I getting steroid? And don't wait for long explanations with the doctors. They need to see a lot of patients. And healthcare workers at that point of time, use your tone to touch the patient. It's not essential that you need to pat the patient. Your tone is a pat. Laser is a pat. And tell them steroids is also because we need to control the infection. Remdesivir we're giving because we feel it is necessary for you at this point of time. And this laser, it does not take time for good tone and good laser. And that I think is so important. Having said this, as you see your others going out from the room and getting discharged, take their phone numbers. Not that you talk to them all the time, just that you feel connected to the big world. You slowly start feeling a sense of belonging. And if you get worse and if you're in the ICU, remember, as the oxygen enters your lung, energy is entering your lung. And do exactly what the doctor say. And if your right arm and your left arm is free, wave at people who are going up and down. People who have remained cheerful have survived bad emergencies. People who have remained connected have survived bad emergencies. Having said that, sometimes you'll find that you're very angry at the doctor who's standing far away. A wink at him and say, "Thoda nazdik aao yaar, kuch nahi hoga tumko. We respect you." And we'll feel nice if you come a little closer. The best way to break the ice is humor, and humor can also be used in a cemetery appropriately. Humor can also be used in a mortuary appropriately. Humor can also be used in a ward which is tense appropriately. So do not ask for a single room. Wave at the patients, wish them good morning, your patients in the neighbor good evening. If somebody is reading a book, if you are stimulated, ask your carers to get that. And that I think is important. So easy chats. And as far as carers are concerned, call your relatives in the ward and don't ask for parameters all the time. They will tell you the parameters, but ask, tumne aaj bhi kisse baat kiya? Tumne aur kuch kiya kya? Doctor ka chehra kaisa tha? Doctor, tumhare utne tense the kya? And then you'll find things settling down. At the same time, be realistically assuring to your cure. Don't give false hopes. Tum 7 din mein bahar aayega? Say, no, we have had a call from the doctor that you might need a little longer. And you need to take a little longer. Give advisories to connect. Don't allow the patient to be called by each and every relative. Filter the calls, as I've said, even during quarantines, and limit the calls. Avoid answering medical questions. Sometimes the person in the ward is not happy with the medical answer from the doctor in the ward. And he might ask you, or sometimes he needs one answer to be repeated again and again so that it sits. And above all, have faith in the doctor and have faith in your carers. As Dr. Shashank said, this infection is highly transmissible as of now, but less lethal. And in my among my friends and among my close relatives, I've yet to see the lethality. So communication strategies, managing anxiety, staying connected. I'm a vice president in a company, but the person adjacent to my bed is a maid servant of a doctor. So what? COVID has made the world flat, and let's accept that. In a flat world, everybody is equal. Hierarchies are man-made, doesn't matter. COVID does not respect any hierarchy. So be connected to a maid servant, to a clerk, even if you are a vice president or a CEO of a company.
Thank you so much, Dr. Shetty. Dr. Joshi is back. We have quite a lot of questions from the audience, Dr. Shetty, if I may ask Dr. Joshi.
Please ask.
Yeah. Dr. Jagruti Dhabuwala says, after inserting finger and pulse oximeter, after how much time should the reading be noted?
After at least a minute. And it's very crucial to do that. Holding the appropriate pulse oximeter. There are so many live videos. Anirudh, I would also say that we can make a small animation video for the same and upload it. Reading it appropriately is very crucial. And after that, you should first measure it, then do a 6-minute brisk walk, and then again measure it. And if you have a cardiopulmonary condition, ask a doctor. This is the best test for COVID to know whether a COVID is having happy hypoxia or not. And if there is a drop of 3% between the baseline and the 6-minute walk, or if the overall pulse saturation, oxygen saturation is less than 94%, you should immediately have a red alert and contact a doctor. Probably start an oral tablet of steroids with consultation with a medical doctor and get some oxygen on board, because that is a very crucial sign that something is impending and you need to take and get medical attention. So that's so crucial to save lives. And that 6-minute walk test is crucial. Using the pulse oximeter is very crucial. In the good old days, we were doing thermal screening and thermometer. That is very important in the new virus also. But apart from thermometer, pulse rate, blood pressure, respiratory rate, pulse oximeter or oxygen saturation and blood pressure, these are some tools which people can do and measure at home itself. And therefore, if you have hypertension, if you have diabetes, keep a glucose checking machine and a blood pressure checking machine. It always helps, because you can measure and talk to your doctor on the phone because you are isolated. And if you do these simple things and do not panic, use clinical common sense, stay connected with your doctor, you can do very well with COVID. There is nothing to panic. There is nothing as good as home, unless there is a red signal or a red flag where you need to rush to a hospital, where they will do a CT scan, put you on some prone position, so try to lie on your chest and give you some high flow nasal oxygen, give you some steroids, give you some remdesivir, and probably if needed, they will, if you deteriorate, then they will give you some high-end medicines, and sometimes you may need a ventilator. But usually that is a rarity. But if you do things on time, then you know, timing is crucial. See, the main thing in COVID is timing. The other thing which is discussed often is COVID clots, because you know what happens is when this time starts, the time has two speeds. One is the cytokine, which are the chemicals. Second are the clots. To prevent clots, we use this injection of low molecular heparin sometimes, which is called as clexane or enoxaparin, 40 milligram once or twice a day. Or sometimes we give oral tablets, which are like aspirin, but they are like anticoagulants, novel anticoagulants like Eliquis or dagibatran or apixaban and so on, or Xarelto. These are some of these tablets which are also used. So in consultation with your doctor, again, I'm reiterating, in consultation with your doctor, every COVID case is different. And the timing is crucial in COVID, and being alert and not being complacent. Be alert throughout the time, but be cheerful. And if you are able to do that, it can make you, you know, stronger and better after COVID.
Absolutely. There's one beautiful sentence by a psychologist, Amin Pritkar, I would like to read it to all our viewers. The more we talk about our illness, we are reliving those moments, and then body takes all the more time to heal. You need to talk, but as much as we can, as we should. Knowing the difference between expression and experience makes a difference. That's beautifully said. Anirudh, there is, you can see that question by the Indian space biologist. Can you ask that to Shashank?
Which one is that, sir?
Can overaction of immune system be prevented by diet, including probiotics such as curd, yogurt, fermented based foods?
No. So overactive immunity, you know, by the time the immune system is overactive and you get a cytokine storm, you need monoclonal antibodies, you may need a tocilizumab or itolizumab or a steroid. But early in the disease, when you are actively having disease, for building your immunity, some of all these agents may work. So remember, most of these natural remedies are useful when you don't have COVID or when you have mild or asymptomatic COVID. But when there is moderate to severe COVID also, there might be some agents. Because remember, most of the allopathic drugs, except prone position, oxygen and steroids, have not been shown to use mortality. They may aid recovery, like favipiravir may aid viral clearance, remdesivir may aid recovery by a day. So we might get some alternative medications where the recovery may improve. But we need to generate some evidence based on that. But probiotics and curds necessarily do not have any dramatic data till date published to show that it makes a difference. But having good gut microbiota are always good to fight infection. because there are three types of our immunity in the body. One is the local immunity, second is the gut immunity, and third is the systemic immunity. And in the gut immunity, the microbes of the gut in the colon play a large role in gut immunity.
Absolutely. My friend Anirudh, just have a look at Dr. Meena Iyer's question and Rohit Singh's question for Shashank, and then after that I'll come in. You're mute.
Dr. Meena Iyer asked,
I have not been given vaccine till date. I have severe unexplained urticaria and angioneurotic edema. My CRP is okay, eosinophils are fine. My physician is telling me to wait. Probably you are a contraindication for vaccine. If at all you have to look at a vaccine, you'll have to probably look at a Covaxin. And between your allergy specialist, who will do a desensitization protocol for you, and you can take a call. Covishield is out. It's only Covaxin. If at all you are eligible to receive one after getting formal immunology and allergy clearance. So remember that whenever you get into a situation like this, and it could be a doctor or a patient, where the doctor feels that you can't take the vaccine because you have had some life-threatening episodes in the past due to food or medicine allergy, then you need to go to an expert called clinical immunologist or an allergy specialist who will map your allergy, identify your allergy, do a desensitization protocol, and then under supervision will administer you the vaccine. So remember that vaccine, there is no contraindication, but accept anaphylaxis or angioneurotic edema, which was rightly fully said so. And for you, the strongest vaccine is double masking 24/7. And except when you are at home alone, I think you will have to be always in a mask. And that probably is equally protective.
There's another question from Rohit Singh, and then I'll come for Dr. Shashank. You can see that that question. He has a one-year-old child whom he wants to take him to the park occasionally when it is less crowded. The kid still doesn't wear the mask.
Yeah. When is it okay to take the one-year-old child to the park? Basically, that's the question.
So remember, the kid below 2 years, we don't recommend masks. All over the world, they have not been recommended. But you know, if you're going to take them out to an outside park, which is zero crowd, it is absolutely okay. Otherwise, you can take them to the gallery. You can take them to a place in your society where, or a terrace in your society where there is nobody. So then you are absolutely safe. Taking them to a park has a risk involved in it, because you know, the kids pick up the virus very fast. And once they pick up the virus very fast, they may recover very fast, but they will pass it on to everybody at home, and they become spreaders and super spreaders. So I think you need to be a little more innovative and intelligent to ensure that the kid gets the space and the play space the kid requires. At the same time, you need to work into a safe space and a safe play space, which is alone and which is decontaminated and sanitized.
Anirudh, I can see a question from Jaunpur by Ramesh Pal. I have recovered from COVID in 2020. With this wave, I'm scared. All the memories are coming back to me. Shashank, I would like to answer this question. The first half, but the second half, I think you can also pick up. If the memories of the first exposure and your first illness in 2020 have been difficult, and you have blocked all those memories and never shared it, this is the opportunity to relive it and share it. So this is normal. It's like this. If I had a hit on my hand and a fracture and it was repaired, the second hit might open the pain of the earlier wound if the wound is not completely repaired. So that is something which we need to do. So if it's an opportunity to heal yourself, to relive those memories, either with your family, with your teachers who understand you, or with the counselor, and let those memories be quarantined, let the energy around those memories leave you, which means the feelings, and the memories are treated by simply a ventilation or catharsis, or through some other therapy if required. So all those who have been hospitalized earlier, all those who have been treated earlier, may have a second bout of an emotional trauma, may not be COVID infection, and they might feel extremely scared and might see all those memories of the ward or in the ICCU, and this needs to be managed probably by a psychologist, and if not a psychologist, sometimes if you need a psychiatrist. Also what is important is don't block those memories when it's happening now. Tell them, mujhe aise hi lagta hai, mujhe lagta sach vatta tapad kya kar raha hai, matlab kal raat se sopne wale, maybe he or she might require some medication along with helping him or her relive it so that it can be quarantined. But sometimes when you relive the memories, you might get drowned in the turmoil, and to protect yourself from that, there would be a family doctor, a family physician, a psychologist or a psychiatrist, which is very important. At this point of time, I would like to also ask Anirudh if I can share my mantra, and I would like to ask Prashant first. What is your mantra for yourself and for your family and for everybody in the second wave? And after that, I would come in.
So I think, you know, we have to protect ourselves and we have to practice what we preach. So whenever you are alone, you can be unmasked. Whenever you are with, even with your family members, try to sanitize surfaces, and keep yourself environment which is clean, open air, ensure that you have clean air. Beyond that, try to keep a distance, avoid all crowds, as much as possible do everything virtually, and mask whenever you are out or when you are with the interaction. And if you have an unmasking situation, then ensure that you are staying in a bubble. Because if you are staying in a bubble where you know for sure that these people are RT-PCR negative or RAT positive negative, then only it is useful. Otherwise, do not take a chance. I would say for 2 weeks, Dr. Shetty, Anirudh, and I would appeal to every viewer of this program, for 2 weeks, please stay home and take a step back. I feel self-isolate, self-lock, and get out of all these COVID things, unless it is mandatory, essential, life-threatening, absolutely mandatory. If you can stay at home, you will protect yourself and your near and dear ones. That is my only appeal, because when there is community spread in a contagious environment of the second spread, it is better to be wise than late. That is my only simple advice, Guru Anna. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. In fact, I would like to share my mantra as Anirudh shares his fifth slide. And they really my guards are on, double mask, as well as all other things. I accept reality. Accept this virus is very highly transmissible. I will attempt to change it. And as Shashank and me and Anirudh again repeat, when an alcoholic recovers, he becomes an ex-addict counselor. When a drug addict recovers, he becomes an ex-addict counselor. When a patient who has had transplant, liver transplant, like Dr. Suchak, he starts talking about it to everybody else. So we would like all those who have recovered from COVID and all those probably who have lost their family members to come to our show and argue and plead to my country, our country, and to the earth to change your reality and be careful. We repeat this appeal to all those who have lost family members, all those who had serious COVID infection, to write to Anirudh Sapatnikar on the chat that they would be available, and you would be happy to get these COVID ambassadors to talk to people. An ex-addict counselor is very effective when he talks to addicts, and he has a role. So we want ex-COVID traumatized people to come out and say,
absolutely,
save yourself, and that is something. Also, I will fight learned helplessness. Learned helplessness is a phenomenon. Abhi to hone wala hai, kuch nahi kar sakte. Jo hoga, dekha jayega, upar wale ke haath mein hai. And that's what happens to a lot of women. Husband beats them up once, she fights, and then she collapses and says, maar khana hi sach hai. COVID suffer hona hi sach hai. Let's beat that and let's say we'll fight it out by keeping our guards on. We also realize that in spite of all the precautions, I had a call from a doctor, a psychiatrist, who used all his precautions but still got infected. So if I get infected, I'll do exactly what Dr. Shashank has said, and I will follow all the instructions. So we repeat this request to all those who have had deaths in their family, to all those who have had very serious COVID infection survived, to come to our show. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Shetty and Dr. Joshi.
Yeah. This is not working. I have bought a new thing, spending 20,000 rupees, and nothing has worked. I'm back to square again. And it's so,
thank you so much.
Right now it is stable.